So what I did not show in between the previous step and this step is the burnishing of the mouth area of the holster. Basically, anything in between stitch lines, between here and here, is going to be really difficult to burnish after it's sewn together. You can see how much more smooth it is on the top there as compared to like the rough side. So it's been burnished from the stitch lines. It's nice and smooth. And this is one of those areas where you can spend pretty much as much time as you want trying to make it look nice. And it is kind of a wear item, so it's gonna eventually kind of look ugly anyway. So I do it reasonably well. I don't get all too crazy about it. I know some people will burnish them, and then they put edge coat on it and let the edge coat dry, which is almost kind of like a vinyl type of sealer that goes on the edges, and they'll let that dry, and then they'll actually go over it with a piece of denim, almost to the point where it starts to melt. And they do that several times until you physically cannot, or you visually can't see the seams in the leather. And I'm not going to get that crazy. But anyway, so I burnished this piece here, and then also the edges up around here, down through here, in between the stitch lines. So these two pieces are ready to glue together. So one thing you want to do is transfer your stitch lines onto this piece, because if you glue the two pieces together where the weapon's supposed to go, it isn't going to work. So same as kind of process as before, just kind of squirt some of this barge cement on there. And again, this is simply going to hold it in place until it's going to hold it in place just so I can sew it. It's pretty much all it's going to do. But you do want to kind of spread it out a little bit so it doesn't leave any big bumps. And you want to stay away from the edges too. Because when I go to finish the edges, if there's any cement there on the ends, it's going to not take any of the edge coat or the dye very well. So this is really, really a pain in the rear to do on camera. Without messing it up. So that's pretty much that. These two pieces on together here. Now, once this dries, what you won't see on camera is me taking this over to the belt sander and squaring all these edges up. The next time you see it, I don't know, I may have it sewn together completely. We'll see. Hopefully I can get to having it formed tonight. We'll see. Gotta let the glue dry first. There's not much I can do until that happens. So anyways, stay tuned. We'll be forming the leather and getting the gun fit in soon. So, thanks.